got some good ones in here.
Nice.
Guten yarding, everybody. Today's video is extra special because we are inviting a few members of our community in to show us a harvest that has its ties in Guten yarding. And because we are celebrating our potato and sweet potatoes, as you might guess, this is a sweet potato harvest. Now, what we did was at the beginning of the season, we took a couple of sweet potatoes and gave one each to a few of our community members who had never grown sweet potatoes before. And we asked them for one thing: to give us a little bit of footage or even some photographs at the end when they harvested. Now, we walked them through the process of putting the sweet potatoes in water and propagating slips, and then we talked to them about how to harvest those sweet potato slips and plant them. So the sweet potatoes that they grew and that you're going to see here in just a little bit come from a single sweet potato each, and the slips that they propagated there, and then they planted in two different methods. So the first person we're going to show you planted their sweet potatoes in grow bags, and the second person planted their sweet potatoes in the ground. Now again, this is the first time either of these individuals have grown sweet potatoes, and so this was a brand new experience, and they were able to follow our instructions through the process, and you're going to see the results. I love the fact that they were willing to share. We appreciate that very much, and I hope you enjoy taking a look at these harvests.
So when we came out here to check on our sweet potatoes this week, we noticed that the bunnies and squirrels have had a feast day on all of the leaves. These are covered with leaves that looked like this, and they were looking great. And then they just took full advantage of this free buffet this week. So we're gonna try to harvest them and see what we get. So we're hoping that the most efficient way to do this is to dump this upside down and then dig through the dirt. So let's see if it works.
Nice. We got some good ones in here.
Nice.
Now, one of the things you could probably notice here in a couple of these sweet potatoes is that they do seem to be split. Some of the bigger ones are split. And one of the common reasons that happens is a little bit of excess moisture at the end of the growing season. They swell up a little bit too quickly and they bust open. But they're still delicious. They're still perfectly edible. The shelf life might be a little bit shorter, but that's not a problem. Let's continue on. Even if you're getting some of these smaller sweet potatoes, they are still fantastic. They make, as we call them, sweet potato fries, no problem whatsoever. And these bigger ones, absolutely perfect as well.
Here's a nice one.
And one thing to remember, they took one sweet potato and they got all of these slips that they propagated and were able to plant multiple growing bags. And all of this, this harvest that you're about to see.
So this was our first time trying to grow sweet potatoes, and we're really happy with how it turned out. Some of them are on the smaller side. We got some medium ones. And then a couple really big ones, actually. This one's quite big. So overall, we're really happy with how it turned out. We'll definitely try it again next year. This is what we got from 3 grow bags that we had planted and started this spring. So we're hoping to try even more next year, and we're excited now to clean these up and eat them.
I love the fact that they got a bucket full of sweet potatoes from the single one we shared from our garden. So in a way, these are our distant relatives over here, these sweet potatoes coming from our Guten Yarning harvest from last season. How exciting is that? Now, this second harvest that you're going to see also came from a single sweet potato that was propagated to create, well, as you can see, a pretty massive growth in ground. Now, growing sweet potatoes in ground is definitely a different experience than growing in grow bags or even raised beds. You know, we tried that earlier this season where we harvested some of our sweet potatoes that we had planted in our front no-till garden. And I'll have to say that it's a little bit more of a challenging experience pulling them up out of the ground, but they do tend to get pretty big. And as you can see from what this person harvested, they had some really fantastic results. The size of these sweet potatoes is very impressive in my mind. For a person who is growing sweet potatoes for the first time, this has to be an exceptional introduction into growing sweet potatoes. I know that if I got this kind of results from the very first time I planted, there is no way I wouldn't continue planting these in the future. I actually spoke to this person just recently, and they told me that overall, this was the best garden they had had ever. I'll have to say the same thing. We had a phenomenal year just all around. But if you take a look at this shovel beside these sweet potatoes, it is incredible to me that all of this came from one single sweet potato. Now, one of the things that we've talked about in the past with regard to this channel is that our goal is to spread out the knowledge of gardening to the community and improve and increase people's experiences. And I think this is an example of a way that that is successful, because now we have two gardeners who are experienced, at least 1 year of experience, growing sweet potatoes and who can work to improve and just grow that harvest in the future. And that is something 100% worth being a part of. We really hope you enjoyed this video. And hey, if you haven't tried growing sweet potatoes before, Team Sweet Potato is waiting for you for sure. What a great experience for us. That's rewarding, even though it wasn't our harvest. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give us a like, leave us a comment, remember to share and subscribe, and most importantly, remember, when you're with us, you are good to grow.